Good morning. My name is Eric Gray. I'm the president of Atssb, and I would like to welcome you to the 2021 Atssb Concert Band All-State Concert. I would personally like to thank you for your presence here today, and to the leadership and membership of the Association of Texas Small School Bands for the vision, leadership, and hard work it took to make this event happen. I am most proud and at the same time truly humbled to be counted as a member of this outstanding organization. This event was organized with one group of people in mind, and that is our students. This event had to happen. It had to take place, if for nothing else, but to remind us not to take for granted every opportunity we can give our students to succeed and flourish, and this is truly one of those once-in-a-lifetime opportunities. These students were born to make music, and we absolutely had to do everything in our power to make this happen. I was on the elevator with a student 2 days ago. He didn't know me, I didn't know him. He looked at me and he said, "I just want to say thank you for letting this event take place and making it take place. I'm a senior, I graduated, my life would have gone on without this, but I will remember these days for the rest of my life, and I just wanted to thank you for making it happen." I want to say thank you to Jerry Wharton and the entire band staff, band students, and administration here at Melissa for providing this perfect and impressive venue. I've discovered in our short time working together that Jerry is the dreamer of big dreams. He's been telling us for over a year, "We can do this, guys, we can do this," and he was absolutely correct, and I just want to say thank you. ATSSB is celebrating its 30th anniversary, and we had a celebration luncheon yesterday at the hotel, partially sponsored by Kaleidoscope Adventures, and we thank them for that. At that luncheon, the executive committee honored our executive secretary, Kenneth Griffin, as the first inductee in the ATSSB Hall of Fame. So if you see him after this concert is over, be sure to congratulate him on that honor. He is truly deserving. A lot of work goes on to make this happen, and we have a few more introductions to make before we listen to your students play. Our organizers are the ones that are here early, they stay late, they've been planning for months, and they're doing all of the hard work behind the scenes, so it seems only fair that we give them a moment to recognize them here on the stage. I would like to introduce our apprentice organizer, starting with percussion, Donald Myers from Redwater. Our apprentice band organizer, Jay Sutton, also from Redwater. Our All-State Concert Percussion Organizer, Jim Best, Winsboro. And our All-State Concert Band Organizer, Justin Keltner from Winona. Like I said, these folks have been going after it from well before the students showed up on Wednesday. And they'll be here after they leave, getting everything taken care of. Again, thank you for being here. Your students have had a wonderful time with our clinician, and Dr. Don Lefevre is on the faculty at West Texas A&M University, and he is a household name in band halls and with band directors across the state of Texas. He's been doing this for a long time and has a whole page of accolades and awards there, and I'm going to let you read those. Because I've talked enough and you want to hear your kids play, they have done a great job. Please welcome to the stage the 2021 ATSSB All-State Concert Band directed by Dr. Don Lefevre.
Wonderful overture, isn't it? Written by Alfred Reed, who at one point was one of the most prolific composers for band literature of all time. Nowadays, you almost never hear an Alfred Reed piece performed, and I wanted to introduce that piece to students. It's supposed to be about springtime and youth, and I thought, how better program than to kind of basically state what these students are all about, youth and going into more exciting things. This next piece is special to my heart. It's called Don Hanna. Don Hanna was my high school band director. I met Don Hanna in 1971 as a freshman, moved to Fort Stockton, a little town in South Texas. Little did I know that Don Hanna was one of the best band directors in the state, and I had a great experience. Back to old Don Hanna, my livelihood. I was going to be a business major at Texas Tech University. He called me into my office and he called me Donnie. He said, Donnie, what are you going to do next year? I said, well, I'm going to be a business major at Tech. He says, no, you're not. I said, I'm not. He says, you're going to go to WT and you're going to be a music major. And I said, Mr. Hanna, what are you talking about? Well, guess what? That's what I did. And you know what's amazing about that story, now that I'm old enough to reflect, I should have had that conversation with my parents. So parents, I'm reminding you something today. Have that conversation. Luckily, I had a fantastic mentor in Don Hanna who steered me in the direction that I needed to be going in. Thank you, Mr. Hanna. He passed away in 2014. This wonderful piece as a tribute to Don Hanna was written by Gabe, Musella. Gabe works in the UIL office in Austin. He's one of the music directors there. They have a wonderful staff in that UIL office. They organize all kinds of events throughout the year. Gabe is a big part of that. And this piece means a lot to me. And
it's been great to share it with the band and now with you. Don, Hanna. To get to be a part of the audience and for the parents to be a part of the performance, right? Especially after something like COVID. So all of you know this great piece by Leonard Bernstein from West Side Story, written in 1961. Mambo is a part of that. Great, great, great music. There's a place in here where we're gonna say Mambo. You'll know where. Thank you. this last piece, before we play this last piece, I need to tell you a few things about your kids that you probably already know. What a wonderful group of students. Holy cow. This has been one of my favorite weeks in many, 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 many years. I really needed something like this. They really needed something like this coming off of the 18 months that we've had, right? I don't know. There's something special about music that brings us all together, lifts us up. Getting to do this event is amazing to me. And for me, for the ATSSB staff and the board, for them to have the vision and the wherewithal and knowing how much effort it was gonna take to pull something like this off, they need a big pat on the back. Give those ATSSB. What a wonderful facility at Melissa. This is so beautiful. Thank all of you guys. And I want to thank all of the organizers that helped me all week. They are amazing people, every one of them. And these students, I have never worked with a better group of students in my life. And I really mean that. This piece was actually programmed years ago, and it's a piece by Brian Balmages. Wonderful piece. He's going to be conducting the next group that you're going to hear, the symphonic band. Well, he's a great composer, wonderful musician, and a great person. Infinite Hope, this the title, is perfect for where we are today after 18 months of this mess that we've been through. We've lost loved ones. Some of us have gotten COVID and struggled through it, but we're prevailing. And we have a bright future ahead of us. And I think that's what this piece is all about, an infinite hope, which is a fantastic idea. And with this type of leader right here, these types of leaders, we're in good hands. We're in good hands. Thank you for being in the audience today, and thank you, band, for being the best group ever. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.